final one is al-asha. Asha, the root letters for that are hamza, seen, and alif. Or ya, you can say it's a ya. And this is regret, really. Regret or sadness over an opportunity that was lost. Or an opportunity that was, I could have done that. Oh, I didn't do it. Didn't work. You're looking back and you keep beating yourself up over what you could have done, and you was right there. If you just did it, things could have been so much better. Why didn't I take that opportunity? A lot of times, people, when they email me, especially with the subject heading being sadness or depression or something, usually has to do with relationships. You know, there was a sister, I wanted to marry her, and I should have proposed, and then she married someone else, and I'm sad every day, and I keep thinking about how I should have got the guts and talked to her dad, and I didn't do it, blah, blah, blah. This is al-asa. But it's also a kind of sadness that's not just on opportunities lost, but it's also a kind of sadness that is that expresses when you did something bad in your past, and you feel like that bad deed you did, whatever it is, don't tell me, whatever it is going to affect negatively everything you do in your future. Like your mistake from the past is going to negatively affect everything you do in your future. This word is al-asa. This is also used in the Quran. And this word, it's important for Muslims to understand, because we're living in a time where the opportunity to do really bad things very, very easily has been made convenient, right? So we can do pretty bad things, spiritually speaking, to ourselves and damage our souls with very little effort. And when that happens, then we get into a state of depression. What kind of scum am I? To the world, where the world thinks I'm Muslim, but look at me on the inside, look at the kinds of stuff I'm up to, how can I even live with myself? And there's this regret over what you've committed in the past, and what most people do when they don't know how to deal with this, is they look at their past mistake, and they define themselves with their past mistake. What I mean by that is, I messed up, that must mean, I messed up in the past, which must mean I am messed up. There's a difference between I messed up and I am messed up. When people mess up, that doesn't mean they are messed up. That just means they messed up in the past. That is no guarantee that they will mess up in the future until they convince themselves that they are, in fact, messed up. The only one who can mess you up is your own conviction. Allah Azza wa Jalla built you with taqweem. You could get hit, that building could get hit, it could get rattled, but you can fix the damage and maintain the building. Or you could say, let it get hit some more until the building collapses. Then don't blame the architect. And don't blame the architect. That's you. You brought that on yourself. You cannot live with that kind of constant negative being brought back over and over and over again. There are mother-in-laws, especially in Desi culture, that relive sad incidents in the past. Or they don't let their daughter-in-laws, or the daughter-in-law doesn't let the mother-in-law, or the father doesn't let the son or daughter, they don't let them get over what happened. Just get over it. Move on with life. They can't do it. They have to bring it up. It happened 20 years ago. Let it go. No. You did not get married without permission. Therefore, it just makes me sad. But it's over. You cried about this for 3 weeks already. Remember all those tears? Remember all those dishes you broke? We did that already. Now I have children, and those children are going to get married. And you're still not coming to the wedding because of what happened for that like 30 years ago. You're making yourself miserable, people around you miserable, because of asa, because you can't let go of the past. And you're letting it cloud the rest of your future. Allah Azza wa Jalla did not want us to have a heavy life or to have a heart filled with sadness. Actually, one of the descriptions of a heart that's full of iman, a beautiful description in the Quran, is qalbun salim. Qalbun salim, so beautiful. The word salim in the Arabic, you know one of its meanings? Healthy. One of the meanings of salim is healthy. Allah wants the believer that comes to Allah on Judgment Day successfully. Allah says, إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Except for the one who comes to Allah with a healthy heart, a sound heart, a heart that is free from damage, meaning emotionally you're sound, not just in terms of your iman. But these emotions have an effect on our iman. Fear, anger, depression, grief, all these things are directly related to our iman.
We are one Ummah who should stand with each other through all the